second running of the Humber Bridge Half Marathon. Put on by Hull Rotary Club. Our Rotary Club was formed in 1920 and was one of the first Rotary Clubs to be formed in Britain. And this year, of course, it celebrates its 80th birthday. So it's all. So we're getting more to the fine end of the event now. The part of the field where to finish is a victory in itself.
It's a speed camera.
Well done, good run.
Morning.
Morning. Hiya. Good run. Well, we now expect that Johannes and Darren are some 3 miles into this race. And Darren shows no signs of surrender to this man who's next really big race is the Olympic Marathon in Sydney. So, cheers.
Good filming it.
So we're now just getting the last few stragglers through before we head off. Before going through another entry on the day, number 1300, and we got up to about 1370 today. Two spectators here, open the vantage point. All the runners now head on to the football. Before he completes this half marathon, a distance of 13 miles, 192 yards, and 18 inches. most remarkable bridges. 1410 metres between its two 500 foot towers. Busy on that footpath, which is 10 feet wide, but there's nobody being impeded particularly. And the sun comes out again. So these runners are perched at 90 feet above the River Humber, courtesy of this huge suspension bridge. Bank run. William Malone there, who was buying a third place today, came second in that event. So all enjoying this run across the bridge. Yeah, you got a car coming fast. So this is one of the testing climbs on the course that leads up to the Barton interchange roundabout. did a large distance this event kind of covering. The gaps are beginning to appear as the runners become more serious. Sealed up this year. That would be a repeat of some of the chaos from last year. Yeah, the 644. We come towards the Market Square. Tom McKee there, City of Hull, recently ran 38 minutes 40 in North East League's 10K. Maybe there, number 177. There's Aaron Walton there. Comes from Barton, but now lives in Market Wheaton. Nice, run them all.